The Broncos are reportedly interested in bringing Brock Osweiler back to Denver. It looks like the Denver Broncos are willing to let bygones be bygones if Brock Osweiler is willing to do the same. According to Mike Klis of 9news.com in Denver, the Broncos are planning to zero in on Osweiler once he officially becomes a free agent. Osweiler was informed by the Browns on Friday that the team would be releasing him. Just 18 months ago, the idea of Osweiler returning to Denver seemed pretty much implausible considering the way things ended between the Broncos and their former quarterback. It all started in March 2016, when Peyton Manning announced his retirement a few weeks after the Broncos' 24-10 win over the Panthers in Super Bowl 50. With Manning out of the picture, the belief in Denver was that Osweiler would take over for the Broncos and become the full-time starting quarterback. However, Osweiler threw a wrench into those plans during free agency when he decided to spurn the Broncos and sign a four-year, $72 million deal with the Texans. Osweiler's decision to leave Denver led Broncos general manager John Elway to rip on his former quarterback on several occasions. 2 months after signing the deal, Osweiler had some choice words of his own for the Broncos. The quarterbacks said he chose Houston over Denver because he felt had a better chance at long-term success with the Texans. "I have tremendous respect for both John Elway and Peyton Manning as people and as quarterbacks in the NFL, but I was not concerned one bit with playing in their shadow," Osweiler said in May 2016. "That didn't weigh into my decision whatsoever. Bottom line, I made my decision off where I felt like I could have the most success playing quarterback in the NFL and where I could go and win long term." Although Osweiler's decision to sign with the Texans made him rich, it completely backfired on the field after he ended up being one of the worst quarterbacks in the NFL in 2016. After just one season, the Texans were so eager to get rid of him that they basically gave the Browns a 2018 second-round draft pick just to take Osweiler and his giant contract off their hands. The Browns then held on to Osweiler for roughly 5 months before informing him that he would be released on Friday. In the year and a half that Osweiler was away from Denver, Elway probably thought he would solve the Broncos' quarterback issues, but that's not what happened. The Broncos gambled on Paxton Lynch with a first-round pick in the 2016 draft, but that gamble didn't pay off. In both 2016 and 2017, Lynch was beaten out for the starting QB job by former seventh-round pick Trevor Siemian. To Elway, it seems that Siemian is basically a stopgap solution at the quarterback spot in Denver, which is probably why the general manager now wants to bring Osweiler back. Elway's original plan was to make Osweiler the starter, and now he can go back to that original plan, and the best part for Elway is that he'll likely be able to do it at his own price. A big reason why Osweiler ended up in Houston is because the Broncos didn't want to match the Texans' offer because they thought Houston was overpaying. 18 months later, we now know that Elway was definitely right about that, and Elway now might be able to get the quarterback he wanted at a bargain. Osweiler spent the first four seasons of his career, 2012-15, in Denver and went 5-2 as a starter in 2015, while Manning sat out with various injuries.